And happy Mother's Day. How many of you are mothers? How many of you have felt like mothers at times? How many of you have mothered a child or a pet or a houseplant? Or a friend. Yes, or a friend. Motherhood takes many, many different forms. And we honor all mothers, and especially our birth mothers today, but all mothers. It's an important energy. We'll be exploring that a little more today with our very special guest. I'm not going to tell you who it is, but we did a lot of work to get this guest here today. So hold on to your seats. And I'd like to welcome everybody. For those of you who are here for the very first time, raise your hand so we can say hi. And ushers, some of you have got your welcome packets. Yes, welcome. We are glad you are here. And all of you who are with us on Facebook, we are glad you are with us. And if you are here either live or on Facebook for the very first time, we want you to know that unity and God leave no one out. We are all beloved children of God just the way we are, regardless of race, religion, nationality, gender identity, or sexual orientation. You are a beloved child of God, and we love you just the way you are, and we are so glad you are here with us. So as we begin our service today, I'm going to turn it over to Michael.
Happy Mother's Day. I have some announcements for May 7th, 2022. The Tai Chi and Qigong classes with Sharon Mon, Monday and Wednesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. in the sanctuary. There is a love offering and donation. Sign up if you're interested, please sign up at the events table in the back or call the office. Second Saturday Coffee House. I have a video for you.
Second Saturday Coffee House. This month featuring the talent of Anna Rudolph. And opening, Josue Borrupia. Catch a new act every second Saturday, only at Unity Spiritual Center. Doors open at 6 p.m.
Now, I have to tell you, most of our volunteers who are there are going to be gone that Saturday. So we are looking for men and some women, if you're not with the WOW. So please, if you're interested, sign up in the back. Huh? Meet out here after church. Thank you. Pride Fest is coming up Friday, May 13th, 2022, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. There's going to be a meeting here. It's a Friday. If you're interested in helping with a booth, please let me know. I will be going around with a clipboard to sign people up, so please let me know. Albuquerque Interfaith Meeting, Sunday, May 15th at 12 noon, fellowship. Learn what volunteers are doing with Albuquerque Interfaith with opportunities for you to volunteer to improve our community for all residents. More information in the weekly online newsletter or website. I have another announcement. Please come on up.
All right, thank you, Michael. We have a special announcement I would like to share with everybody. Tomorrow, we have a special person having a birthday. This person happens to be Reverend Gordon, and I wondered if you would join me singing him happy birthday. The service, we do have a birthday cake, so join us in the fellowship hall and have a slice. All right, thank you.
I have one more thank you, a very special thank you to give to Mr. Brian. This last week I had a concert for my kiddos, my middle school. He came over and played guitar for us at our concert, so thank you very much. Can we go back just one? For information regarding classes, events, donations, please check USC website, weekly online newsletter, and the USC Facebook page or call the office. I'd like to introduce our platform host. That's me. Thank you. You already know our birthday boy, Reverend Gordon. Our prayer chaplains is Susie Orchard and Martine Backman. If they are going to be here after church or after service today for prayers, and if you need a prayer, please talk to them. There's also prayer slips in the back of the chairs, and there's a place where you can drop them off in the back of the foyer. Todd Lowry is our music director. Diana Hughes is our special music. And Miss Lori Roop is our trustee of the day.
Okay, it's time to do our mission, vision, and core values. So if you please join me, our mission. We inspire spiritual growth through honoring many paths, education, prayer, sacred service, and abundant living. Our vision, centered in love, we see a harmonious world of divine expression. Our core values, we are Christ-centered, loving, inclusive, joyous, uplifting, open-minded, and fun. Right. And our unity credo. We believe all people are created with sacred worth. We serve all people in emotional and spiritual ways. We welcome the diversity of all. God and unity leave no one out. Thank you.
All right. It's time for a congregational song. Let's stand up if we're able, and we're going to sing one of my favorites. It's called A Light in This World, I Am a Light. Have a seat.
In this very room, there's quite enough love, one like me, and in this very power to face the way any
Today is blessing mothers. I bless mothers everywhere. When I think of mothers' experiences of love, gentleness, nurturance, and compassion flood my memory. Even if I did not experience these qualities from my biological mother, she did give me life. I give thanks for all those inspiring mothers who did touch my life. To my mother and everyone who has blessed me with a mother's care, I wrap you in kindness and love. I am grateful for your presence in my life and for any sacrifices you have made that gave me the opportunity to grow and learn. You taught me the power of love, gentleness, and the strength found in giving. You taught me by example how to be true to myself. I enfold you with thoughts and feelings of infinite love and peace as I join with others in gratitude and joy today. I bless all mothers everywhere.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And there's quite enough hope and quite enough power to chase away any gloom. For spirit, God's spirit, God's spirit is in this very room.
We're going to get into our meditation with a song called Heart of the Mother. Please join me.
I am one with the heart of the mother. I am one the heart of love. I am one with the heart of the mother. I am one with love.
Do part one again.
I am one with the heart of the mother. I am one with the heart of love. I am one with the heart of the Father. I am one with God.
Let's add the other part.
I am one with the heart of the Mother. I am one with the heart of love. I am one with the heart.
With the heart of the mother, the power, the energy of love. As I rest in that warm embrace, I think of my mother and all mothers. Mothers who have birthed, nurtured, and raised. Generation upon generation of my ancestors. Going back thousands of years, how many women have given birth? How many have raised their children? My mother, my grandmother, my great-grandmother, my great-great-great-grandmothers going back. I feel that loving energy flowing down through the ages. Through the ages. That nurturing power. That life-giving power. And I know too, regardless of my gender, that I have that energy for female and male. We birth dreams, hopes. We create and we nurture our creations to fulfillment. The energy of mother is life itself, human life, animal life, plant life, the very life of evolution. Everything that has ever been built or created has been done so through the energy of motherhood. Car alarms remind us that energy of motherhood somebody's yellow car, we bless that car. Some of our mothers have senses of humor. And that too is part of motherhood. How many times do we laugh at our children? Not out of mockery, but out of empathy. As they take their first toddling steps. As they go through all the adventures and misadventures of growing up. Motherhood is humor. It is patience. But more than anything else, it is the energy of the future. We honor our mothers in so many ways. More than just on Mother's Day. I think of the mother energy of God and all the many mother versions of God. Ama, Asherah, Sibyl, Hera, Isis, Gaia, Kamakhya, Poonapapi, Lakshmi, Nut, Parvati, Pachamama, Rhea, Sita, Sophia, Thea, Ya, and Yermaha. Names of the mother throughout the ages. The Supreme Mother, the creator of all that is, the feminine aspect of the creator and the creation. I feel that energy emanating from my heart center. The energy of Mother God. The energy of motherhood. The energy that reminds me I too can create. I too can nurture hopes, dreams, other people. And as I prepare to rest in silent wonder, I allow that energy of motherhood to flow through every cell of my being, bringing new life, new ideas, new hopes. In this silence, I rest in the arms of Mother God. In this embrace, I send a special blessing to my mother and to all mothers. Thank you, God, for mothers and the mother energy. Without which, none of us would exist and nothing would be. And I say, thank you, God, as I return to this now moment.
Our special guest singer today is Diana Hughes. Hello, Diana. And she has her first song is a traditional, well, it's not traditional, it's not that old, but it's a beautiful song about anybody who supports other people.
When I am down and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. There is no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so perfectly. But when you to more than I can be.
Diana Hughes. Thank you, Diana. She's going to be back with something completely different.
Thank you, Diana, Todd, Brian, and Kent. We so appreciate you and your talent. And speaking of talent, today we are very specially blessed to have someone who is coming to visit us, not just from far away physically, but from far away through time and space. We've worked really hard to channel this person to visit us. She's very special to Unity. If you haven't guessed who it is yet, it is the mother of Unity, Myrtle Fillmore. So Myrtle, would you come up, please? Yeah. Well, Myrtle, I am so happy that you are here today. And for those of you who may be here for the first time and don't know who Myrtle is, Myrtle Fillmore was and is the co-founder of Unity Spirit, well, Unity as a movement, and our ancestor spiritually, along with her husband, Charles. We're going to try to get Charles here for Father's Day. We'll see. He's a little harder to work with sometimes. But we are so glad that you are here with us, Myrtle. And we know it's been quite a journey. And before we get started, I just want to say how much we appreciate you traveling across time and space to be here with us.
It was quite a commute, Reverend Gordon.
I can imagine.
Well, good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here with you all today. Before leaving this earthly realm, I explained I was leaving so that I could be of more assistance to the Unity movement from the other side. Unity Spiritual Center, Albuquerque, and all of you are very special because I have assisted you since your foundation in 1924 by Reverend Minter. I also know this fellow very well. Your ministers have reached out to me many times over the years for assistance in some challenging moments, and I've given them and all of you some spiritual assistance. I hope you know that Charles and I continue to hold all of you and all of our ministries in our hearts and prayers. For though we have gone on to the next experience of being, we know there can be no separation in time and space. I hear your prayers, and I assist you every day with mine.
Thank you, Myrtle, for telling us that. It is good to know that you are on the other side there, holding our Unity Center and all Unity Centers in your hearts and prayers. And I know that we here at Unity Spiritual Center in Albuquerque have not achieved all that we have achieved through closing in on 100 years in Albuquerque under our own steam. There was a much divine assistance and spiritual assistance from other realms and other places supporting us in all that we have endeavored to do. And might I say that since you were born in 1845, you're looking really good for 177 years old.
Well, thank you, Gordon. But today I feel more like 69, actually. Charles and I knew that when we lived on this earth plane, we taught all of our followers not to give power to the aging process. And in truth, I only came into my own in my 60s and 70s, and we were both vibrant and strong in our old age which I encourage all of you to be. When I passed on, it was not due to ill health or disease, but because I chose to, in order to be of more use and offer more powerful spiritual assistance from the other side. Before I left, I went around the Silent Unity building and all of the offices, and I reminded each of the employees just how special and beloved they were. Then I went outside to the, what you call the Myrtle Fillmore garden, and I went into meditation and chose to leave the vehicle that had carried me so well through that life. I was simply letting go of the physical and freeing myself to be of even greater service in another form. For you see, we are all spiritual beings inhabiting a body. We want to keep our vehicles functioning perfectly, but there comes a time when we just let that go and move on to another experience of life. That's not to say that the life you're experiencing right now is not important. It is. Each of you have come to this place in time to fulfill a sacred soul purpose. It's different for each of you, but by being together with like-minded people, you support one another in your soul mission. For some, it may be a life of learning about health, love, abundance, peace. The list is endless. For some, it may be a life of being a teacher. And I would say for most, it's a little bit of both. Learning and teaching. Each life and each life experience is a step forward in our evolution.
Well, Myrtle, I know that in your life here, you were both. You learned hard lessons about your health with your overcoming of consumption, I believe you called it in your time. And then you took what you had learned and you taught it to others. Can you share with us some of the tips you have how we can be both learners and teachers?
Well, yes. Use your minds well and carefully to guard against negative thoughts. Live healthily from the spirit that is within you. Remember this, every little cell in your body is a living, thinking organism. As such, those cells have intelligence. They respond to thoughts about them, just as children respond to thoughts and words about them. Speak words of gratitude to your organs and tissues and bones and each cell. Let them know how much you appreciate them carrying you through this life. They work hard on your behalf. But know this, if you think negatively about them, even if they seem to be less than whole in the moment, that too will affect them. They respond to the frequency of your thoughts and words. Thoughts and words of limitation or condemnation are low frequency. Destructive. Thoughts and words of appreciation and love are high frequency, healing and energizing words.
That is true, Myrtle. Thank you for that reminder. We've been talking a lot this year about frequency and vibration and how it affects our bodies. So with that as a starting point, let me remind everybody that historically it was your ill health that was the starting point for what would become the foundation of the Unity Movement. You had tuberculosis in your early adult years, which often left you weak and bedridden. And if I read this right, by the age of 41, you were pretty much on your deathbed, and you were invited by a friend to go hear a metaphysical teacher named E.B. Weeks, who was giving a lecture tour and was visiting Kansas City. Why don't you tell us about that experience and what it was that you heard that so changed your life?
Oh, dear E.B. Well, it's important to realize that these were desperate times for me. I was told that I was dying from consumption and only had a short time to live. And I was a new mother and a wife with a 4-year-old and 2-year-old who were relying on me to care for them, as well as my husband, Charles. Mr. Weeks was a seminary student and an associate of Emma Curtis Hopkins, who is known as the teacher's teacher. Charles took me to the lecture, I was open and receptive to a miracle. I wanted to live for my family. During the course of his lecture, I heard Mr. Weeks say words that pierced my soul and gave me a whole new vision of myself. I am a child of God, and I do not inherit sickness. I want you to pause and take that in, especially if you have an illness or disease that is dominating your life, particularly if you, like me, had grown up being told you were sickly or weak, or if you were ever told that you were less than capable, less than talented, less than beautiful, or any other untruth about yourself. I want you to take in these words. I am a child of God, and I do not inherit sickness. I am a child of God, and I am divinely endowed with all the gifts that God has: talent, intelligence, beauty, capability, and wholeness. Take these words into your heart and soul, and let them speak to the very cells of your body, of your being, your true being. Let them call forth your true identity. Let those words take hold of your awareness, and let them minister to you as they ministered to me all those years ago. You know, I heard nothing else that Mr. Weeks said except for those words that became my truth and the truth of my being. In that moment, I knew in the core of my being I wasn't sick or ill and I wasn't going to die. I knew that the one true power and the one true experience and presence that was within me was my life, it was my vitality, and I knew there was no other life to be had. I left that lecture convinced and knowing that I was already healed and that I was a different person than the one who had gone to the lecture. I had found my true identity.
I see. And in fact, you spent the next 2 years healing yourself using those words. From what I've read, you spoke to all of your organs, your tissues, and your cells, and you told them how much you loved them. You even apologized to them for having treated them so badly and thought so lowly of them throughout your past illness. How you had judged yourself and your body negatively for being sick all of those years. Doing that work, eventually in 1888, the doctors declared that a miracle had happened and you were free of consumption.
Yes, indeed. You see, I spoke words of truth to my body, to my organs, my mind, and my cells. I stopped telling myself lies about who I was and how powerless I was. I grew up in a strict religious household where I didn't have a very good opinion of myself in relation to God. Many of you can relate, I'm sure. You see, the image that you have of God and who you are in relationship to God is crucial in life, especially in all healing work. I told every part of my being that I was a child of God, and it responded to the truth of those words. You must know it in your bones.
And I think it's important to acknowledge that it did take you 2 years to heal completely. It was not instantaneous. You had to do a lot of prayer work and speaking aloud and silently words of truth before your body fully responded. Now, for us modern day people, 2 years seems like an awfully long time. Am I right? Yeah. But did you ever feel like you were giving up or that you weren't going to be healed fully?
For the best part of 40 years, I had been feeling weak and sickly, so 2 years was nothing. But more importantly, those words that I heard, I am a child of God and I do not inherit sickness, were what I would call anointed words. There was a power in them that moved my soul, and I was convinced by them of the truth that they told me. You could say I believed and I had faith in them to bring about the change externally in my physical form that they so assured me of on the inside. I knew in my soul that I wasn't sick and that I would never be sick again once I regained my health fully. The body just took some time to catch up to what the mind already knew. Maybe it took some time because I needed to understand how the healing process took place in order to be able to teach it to others later when we founded Unity. My healing experience of speaking spiritual words of truth to the physical realm became the foundation for all our work in Unity.
Yes, indeed. And your husband Charles was so affected by your healing that he became an ardent seeker of truth in his own life and became the great mystic whose writings taught many the secrets of our wonderful spiritual movement. Although I would add that we really don't keep them secret.
Correct. You see, the conviction that came with those words created a whole new body for me. There was no longer any thought of illness or weakness. There was only confidence and strength and moving ahead and sharing this good news with others and helping others to heal just as I had. There was this burning desire within me for others to experience in their body and lives what St. Paul calls the glorious freedom of the children of God. Because I went from a life of slavery to the physical realm to freedom of health and wholeness. I went from despair and despondency to joy and hope. In time, Charles and I summed up our philosophy in one line of scripture, Christ, our hope of glory. Once we came to realize that we were loved children of God, then we came to know that each of us is a Christ. We came to know that the presence and power of God lies within us as our true identity.
And we have been so appreciative of that teaching that is the heart and soul of our Unity movement and what we believe. And we know that we can use that power through meditation to bring about healing. And no matter where we are on our journey, something within us is always seeking to be healed. It may be physical, it may be emotional, it may be our thought people. They're all asking to be healed. So Myrtle, would you lead us in a healing meditation as we end our time together?
I'm so glad you asked. My beloved family of Unity Spiritual Center, it is my joy to lead you in a healing meditation. I want nothing more than for you to have the healing experience that I had. And know that you can have it right now. Expect a miracle. We are going to get to the heart of it. The presence of God, which is in your heart, as love. First of all, I invite you to relax by taking a deep breath and relax into the presence of God. There can't be healing where there is worry. Healing with the anxiety, healing in fear. There can only be healing with hope, healing and expectancy, healing and wholeness. So we breathe in fully the life of God, and we let go of any and all other distractions as we breathe out. And breathe in confidence, faith, conviction, knowing, truth. And we breathe out any untruth and allow it to dissolve into the ethers. The Christ of my being, my perfection, my wholeness, my perfection and my divine inheritance, I claim right here and right now. There is only one idea about me, and it is the divine idea that I am a loved child of God. I am made in the image and likeness of my mother, father, God, in the image and substance of spirit. I release and let go any and all other ideas. I know the truth of my being. I am whole, perfect, and complete. I allow the truth of those words to fill my mind and thoughts. I am healed and I am whole. My body and my being are filled with the truth of God's own wisdom. I speak now to any body part that has been identified in the past as sickly or ill. I speak the words of truth to it. Be whole. Know who and what you are. I allow the divine to renew and revitalize every cell of my body right now. To be whole. Accept your divine inheritance. You are loved unconditionally. There is no other truth. I release any false beliefs as I go forth in my life from this moment. I affirm the truth of my being, and so it is. Amen.
Amen. Wow. Thank you, Myrtle. We're truly blessed to have had you with us today. Thank you so much for being here.
It was my pleasure, Gordon. I do hope I may visit again. Until then, I want all of you at Unity to know that you are always in Charles and my hearts and prayers. You are divinely watched over and guided by the omniscience of God. And please remember, Unity Spiritual Center here in Albuquerque is here because you are needed here at this time. You have a mission and a purpose to bring to your city and the world our Unity teachings. I love you. Thank you. And happy Mother's Day.
Thank you, Myrtle. Let's hear it for the mother of Unity, Myrtle Fillmore. And for her willing channel, Martine. Thank you, Martine. That was a lot of fun. But the message holds true. And I do believe that Myrtle and Charles are always holding unity in their hearts, in whatever form they are in right now. For they promised that when they went on. And the unity movement continues to grow after all of these years. So if you have not read Myrtle Fillmore's healing letters, I would invite you to read them. They are powerful, and they speak more in depth of what Myrtle shared with us today. So to all of you, happy Mother's Day. Namaste.
Okay, there we go. So there are a lot of Mother's Day songs out there. I choose this one. Just because is it the credo that says we're fun here? Okay. Keep that in mind, okay? Everything I just lost my. Give me a C. Oh, there it is. Everything I ever learned that got me through the worst. I learned that my mama's anytime I'm turned around, I turn to Mama first, and you'd be wise to memorize what Mama says to me. Standing in the shower, who can argue with that? Mama says, don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at, and Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down. Coffee while lying down in bed. Don't even give it a thought. Mama says, don't eat anything that's bigger than your head. Is she a wizard or what? And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you drive up a mountain, don't back down. Mama makes a lot of sense if you know how to listen. She's clear and concise. Daddy says I love her, but she's got marbles missing. But I say, hey, it's free advice. And she makes me think twice. Mama says, what you believe in is all you really own. And I believe that it's true. Mama says, if you've got doubts, well, my dear, you're not alone. Now it's all up to you. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. I'm just singing what was written, okay? One, two, three. And Mama says it doesn't matter if you drive a hard bargain or drive around town. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down.
So much fun. It is time for our love offering and tithing. Love offerings and tithing are the sustaining life of Unity Spiritual Center here in Albuquerque. Whether attending in person or viewing on Facebook Live, we're grateful and gratefully asking for your support. You may donate at our website at www.uscabq.org. Or you can text to give, and there's the number up above. If you are here in person, you can also give at one of our, with one of our lovely ushers. All right. Please join me for the prosperity blessing. In a universe overflowing with the allness of God, all the needs and desires of Unity Spiritual Center
and those we serve are bountifully met. From every direction, known and unknown, expected and unexpected, our abundant good is here now. Thank you, God. Children. We have children.
Well, let's do our children some song.
You are walking in the light of God. 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 You are walking, 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 walking in the light of God.
Mother's Day. Oh, thank you. So nice to see you all. We have some kids here today. We also have some teens that are hiding, but they're around. Does anybody want to share what they did today or say hi? The Bela Brand kids are at home, so you want to say hi?
No.
All right. Will you please join me in blessing our beautiful children?
You are a perfect child of God, and God, I love you just the way you are.
Thank you so much.
All right, I think it's time for our peace song, right? Let's stand up and do our peace song.
Yeah.
light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. And all is. Woo-wee! And we're going to take about a 15-minute break so we can have some cake. And then we're going to meet right back in here to talk briefly about the Second Saturday Coffee House. We need extra volunteers this time. Guys, you can volunteer too. I do. We'll see you back here in 15 minutes. Let's go get some cake. And happy Mother's Day.
This went over great.
Do you just have the one child? Is that the son yours? Or
four.
I didn't know that.